To make her brighter, the only ones to make her better, the only.
Stop it on the red carpet. And man, I'm
don't go front. Ladies and gentlemen, shall we all rise? His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Anambra State, Chief William Marabatuko.
Thank you. Exodus protest had gone on peacefully in Oka and other cities of the state with police protection and coverage from the beginning in line with our statutory obligations. I recall addressing the protesters personally on Saturday, 10th October 2020, where I promised to convey their grievances and demands to the Inspector General of Police. This was replicated by some of my area commanders and divisional police officers within a fortnight across the state. It was, however, heartrending when hoodlums suddenly hijacked the protest and launched vicious and murderous attacks on our personnel and facilities on the night of 21 October 2020 in Inewi through the evening of 24th October 2020 in Wule. Regrettably, at the end of these callous attacks, the hoodlums had murdered four of our personnel and injured about 15 other personnel. Sadly, in Osumeyi Division alone, we lost the DPO, Joseph Akbar, and three others. Late Inspector John Oko of the Anti-Core Unit was callously beheaded and his head paraded on the streets of Ogidi area. May I kindly, Your Excellency, respectfully ask for a 1 minute silence for the soul of the departed, Your Excellency. The souls of the departed rest in perfect peace. Divisions were vandalized. Two armored personnel carriers, APCs, were damaged, while 27 police vehicles, along with personal and SB vehicles, were burnt completely. The degree of the carnage makes one wonder what the offense of the police would have been. Your Excellency may graciously attest to this carnage, deducing from your tour of our facilities on the 27th October 2020, of which we remain very grateful. Whilst trying to recover from this onslaught and to pick the pieces of our lives, we humbly make the following prayers to Your Excellency. One, support for the families of our fallen heroes. A modest grant to police personnel who lost valuable personal and household assets in the attacks on their barracks. Provision of patrol vehicles to enable us to resume our patrol duties effectively. Rebuilding and renovation of our stations and barracks as soon as possible. Your Excellency, may I digress to say that I'm aware in your usual magnanimity, you have already directed your engineers, planners to visit some of our facilities to enable you to take further necessary action. We appreciate that, sir. We also plead, Your Excellency, for aggressive enlightenment campaign by the Anambra State Government to drum up support for the police within the state. I want to acknowledge the role of His Excellency in reaching out to traditional rulers and youths of various communities who join the police in the defense of our various platforms during this callous attack. We are aware that the IGP Mohammed Adamu, MPM MNI, recently also embarked on a tour of commands to see the losses personally and encourage police personnel to resume duty. I have gone around on confidence building visits to my personnel, and I can assure Your Excellency that we are ready to reclaim public and security space in Anambra State and sustain the toga of being the safest state in the nation, and also to sustain the toga that really is working. God bless you all, and thank you.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I came here this morning to boost your morale after the Elsa's protest. The Elsa's protest started well, and the Commissioner of Police directed the police to accompany the youths so that they are orderly. That went well day one and part of day two. In day three, hoodlums hijacked that SS protest and tried to wreak havoc in some of your facilities. I also turned around with the CP after the incident to see for myself the level of carnage that occurred. It was very devastating. But I want to sympathize with you for the loss of four of your men, the injuries sustained by 17 of your men, and of course the quantum of destruction on your personal assets and what have you. I'm also here to motivate you to say that if you work for somebody and that fellow appreciates that, it gives you more encouragement to work. It's to show that I appreciate the police in Anambra State. You people have done very well. If there are some people that haven't, there are very few. Most of your men are hardworking, and that's why you've helped us to be situated as one of the safest states in Nigeria. Today, I will be honoring the families of the dead police officers, and of course, I will also be making some presentations to the injured, and more importantly, to the gallant officers that defended your stations. I can single out Ogidi, for example. The DPO Ogidi, what's his name again? Ekure. Is he here? Yes. Please give me a big round of applause. They attacked him repeatedly, and repeatedly he repelled the hooligans. And when I visited that facility, the men and themselves were in very high morale, you know, and they were ready for any eventuality. I also understand that that is not the only station that did that. I was told that Wada Okoko,
D Division,
and some other places did that. But it's the one I see. I went to his own and I saw it, so that's why I'm commending majorly. And I saw how prepared they were. Please sit down, officer. So I'm also going to give you 13 vehicles to support the rapid response team of police. Rapid response team. So what these vehicles are supposed to do is to enable you arrive at the crime scene real time to be able to quell the situation or make arrests of the criminals. Please, I want to caution that I don't want these vehicles I'm giving you to be turned to for social use. Guarding of individuals, traditional marriages, and other stuff. That would be an abuse of this vehicle. I want to also emphasize that NSAS brought a lot of lessons to the police in particular and to all of us in general. To the police, the message from NSAS is no corruption, no brutality against the people you're supposed to protect. That does not mean you won't use your training and the necessary force to make arrest. That's your determination, because that's what you're trained to do. But you understand, when I say no brutality, you should be able to appreciate what I mean by that. You know, I also would like the officers to begin a robust patrol, stop and search, you know, hang out in some corners where the criminals, on our own, we have fixed some of the electric poles those criminals destroyed in order to cause darkness so that they will have a hiding place. So that will be a long way in also assisting you with yourselves to work, you know. So I would like to see you go back to your normal self, you know, normal operational that you are known for, you know, bearing in mind that I give you examples of some of what you said. When I addressed them at the governor's office, one of the things they said then was that the police normally will stop some suspected youths, take their phone, check one or two things, and direct the guy to go to the nearest ATM and collect money, or they will frame the guy. If that is true, that should be a thing of the past, because that would not be acceptable. The youths also complained about torture, brutality, and what have you, with a view to extorting money. Again, that should be a thing of the past. I want you to bring out your professionalism. You're all very well trained, very, very well trained. I know how many months you do stay in some of your programs, and some your senior officers, they even go for overseas programs and what have you. We would like to see some of those things exhibited in your day-to-day activities, you know. I want us to very robustly, we know the key battle areas for the police, for criminality, for crime in the state. Mbok, Opiwek, Oboko, Obosi, Ogidi, Inland Town, and some of the other places. I want you to robustly comb those areas. We should not allow people to live in uncompleted buildings that they don't own. Please, can you please flush them out? Because that's where those criminals hide to be able to attack the police, if you will. So working with your colleagues, PGCP has done very well, bringing the Army, the Navy, the Civil Defense, and other armed-bearing members of our team together, you guys will be able to robustly deal with any challenge that may be posed. So once more, I want to sympathize with you for the loss you sustained, and also to commend you for your gallantry, and request that from this moment onwards, because we are getting to Christmas, and that's when the crime peaks, you know, that will help us to sustain a zero crime festivity this time around, you know. So I thank you for listening, and I will now make the presentations. Thank you.
CSP Joseph Appan, and the next of kin is Constance J. Nyakbe. Hope I got this right. Nyakbe. Yes. Continue, sir.
I said my sympathy. They are getting the sum of 2 million. I said my sympathy. Accept my sympathy.
And then we move to
get one week, eh? 250,000
naira. ASP
is for your personal use. The government will pay for your hospital bills. Get one week. Get one week.
An inspector.
Get well quick.
Inspector Marcel Onyeka.
Sorry, get well quick.
Inspector Oba.
It is for their personal use. The state government will pay for their medical bills. Get well quick.
Inspector Una Godwin.
Sorry.
Sergeant.
Sorry. Get well quick.
Winston Peter.
Sorry. Get well quick.
Emmanuel Sunday is of the obedient division.
Sorry. Get well quick.
Godwin.
Sorry, Godwin. Get well quick.
This other best man stood their grounds and repelled attacks. And also, the area commander, Onicha, does personal patrol himself, mobilizes his men, and is loved by all. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for this great man.
I want to say too that the injured were also are also gallant officers, because they took the injury they sustained because they were defending the place. So I want us to appreciate that if you are not injured, that doesn't mean you are very gallant. So both the injured and non-injured are very great officers that defended the state. On the area command is today being recognized for the gallantry of the people there, the area command. You know, despite the large number of miscreants, we were able to repel these attacks without injuring any of the hoodlums. That's a great feat by yourselves, you know. So I'm appreciating your area command with the sum of 1 million naira.
And the worthy of note is that this money.
Come on, fine. This is to motivate and further support you and your men for the great gallantry exhibited during this crisis, and for your professionalism in ensuring that no loss of lives were encountered in the repair of the attacks. Thank you very much. It's been a serious zone, and you've been doing a great work. You and your men, I must commend yourselves. And again, for repairing the attack repeatedly, you deserve, you and your men deserve some commendation and appreciation. And that's exactly what I'm doing today with the sum of 1 million naira. Thank you. Well, I want to appreciate the Buku Police Division for your continuous gallantry. You know, again, that's a very sensitive area, and during this period, I would like you guys to please comb the place again, flush out all people sleeping on the completed buildings, you know, and and reposition yourselves for Christmas and beyond. Congratulations to Gochukwu. You are your man, 1 million men.
DPO Ambassador.
My great friend, I met him in action in the police station. And today, like I promised, you and your team that we will appreciate you. By the way, I'm going to sign special certificates to all these gallant officers. You know, and my CSO will bring it to you sometime during the week. You know, so this is to appreciate you and your team for your exceptional gallantry during this period. Thank you. I want to appreciate yourselves for the special effort. You know, I'll pause here to appreciate the effort of Anambra youths that helped the police to ward off the attacks in most of the locations. You know, when the crisis was at its peak, I called on the traditional rulers, the president generals, to call out their youths to defend our facilities there. That was effectively heeded to, and they were able to ward off all these marauders that came. You know, I want to also appreciate immensely the B Division in Oka. Thank you.
BPO is loved by all. When the instance protesters got there, instead of attacking them, they started chatting with him, praising him for his good jobs. Professionally, put your hands together for President Garba.
Garba is a lesson in crisis management. He's a man of the people, so to say, there. So when the protesters came, he endangered his own life by coming to the midst. They came in their thousands. He came out and calmed them down. And those guys were able to go back. That was a great risk. For all the stuff that you and your men did, and ensured that they didn't attack your property, I want to appreciate you and ask you to keep the good job going.
Commander,
effectively a man Opiweka only and the environment, and that you know Opiweka is a flashpoint in many of such long activities. They were able to, with the support of the other agencies, able to rid of these marauders, you know. So Uche, I want to commend you and your team for an excellent job. And keep it up. People looking at it, the criminals ran away because of his size. So for your gallantry, you and your men,
Commander,
this is another no-nonsense tip, you know, that help us immensely in crime busting and tackling crime all over the state. I commend you and your team for an excellent performance during the NSAS crisis. You did not sustain any. You did not lose any men or injured anybody, but you were able to cope with the challenge. So, because of this, you have been appreciated. Thank you. Well, we've always had the challenge of cultism in Anambra and many places in Nigeria. This team has been able to help us majorly to arrest the situation. But they still have a lot of work to do. But to appreciate them for the work they did, I want to specially give this to you and your team for an excellent job. Thank you. CP, this gentleman is one of your very gallant officers. I've seen him in action in many places, and he has a lot of future in the Nigerian police. They painstakingly traced the killers of one of my staff, and eventually arrested them, two of them, and they are in court now. You know, so for that excellent job, you and your team have a sum of 2 million naira. Working with our satellite and surveillance cameras and providing information. You know, so Chief Owolabi, I must commend you, very gentle officer. God will bless you and your team. Congratulations. During this period, he looks nondescript, but he's a very he looks nondescript, but he's a very gallant, fearless officer. This recognition is because of the activity before even the SRs and during the SRs, and also what you're going to do going forward to motivate you. Congratulations. 500,000 half a million naira.
Thank you, Your Excellency.
I want to also mention that the Anambra youths in the 179 communities we are mobilized to also assist the police, and I'm using this medium to commend them, you know. Thank you very much.
Corporal 20, this is 5. I'll just tell you if I take it over, sir.
I'm here this afternoon to raise your morale so that you can go back to what you are used to doing, good work for Anambra State. And to help you do that and replace some of your bond vehicles, we are today presenting you with 13 additional rapid response vehicles. Rapid response vehicles to enable you appear real time at the scene of crime and be able to arrest the situation or arrest the criminals. You know, I am particularly happy that most of you are very gallant officers, and we've all learned our lessons from the NSAs. You know, so I encourage you to use these vehicles very well. They are not for social outing. They are not for guarding VIPs. You know, they are strictly for your operational activities. You know, so on this note, it is my pleasure to make that presentation now.
It is my pleasure to present to the Rapid Response Team of Anambra State, 100 in number, these vehicles to assist them in their day-to-day activities in keeping Anambra very safe. A robust patrol will be seen from this afternoon going forward. And we have sent a signal to the criminals that there's no hiding place for them in Anambra. So they should on their own disappear before we make them disappear. You know, so on this note, it's my pleasure to cut the ribbon to commemorate the handing over of these vehicles to the Nigerian Police Force. This is in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Morale!
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 happy day for His Excellency.
Hip, 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 hip. Hooray! Hip, 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 hip. Hooray!